Thanks a lot, sir, for your inspiring words. Now I would like to invite Dr. Ganesh Natarajan, the Vice Chairman and CEO of Zensar Technologies, to throw light as to how industry-academia partnership can strengthen further through projects, and how industry can institutionalize the concept of project mentors within their entire manpower planning, so that in that institutionalization, at least in their entire curve, how these people who have so much of experience, they can help the young students in a institutionalized format. Dr. Natarajan.
First of all, let me congratulate each one of you, because anything that is done which is over and above your normal academic curriculum is always good, and to be recognized for good projects is something that you should be very proud of, so congratulations. I'd also like to congratulate Nitin. I think it's a fantastic concept what you're putting together, because I mean, I'm here primarily because 2 years back we set up a foundation in my father's name. It's called the Nataraj Education Society, and I have a young final year student, Ajay Garg, who is actually the only employee of that society, because he's the person who goes around finding interesting projects, forces me to come and talk in these forums. So thank you, Ajay, for bringing me here. But most important, I think the point you touched upon is extremely crucial, that today we need a simpler mechanism, which is why I said what Nitin said is so appropriate, of getting good students to come together with academic institutions and of course with industry. I mean, I myself studied in the most interesting state of India, which is Bihar, because my father was based there, so I had no choice. So I did my schooling there, did my engineering in BIT Mesra, and I still remember many of us in those, in the small town, and this is 25 years ago, used to worry that, look, I mean, the children in, I mean, Pune and Mumbai and Delhi are getting so many opportunities, what happens to us? And I think this platform that you talk about, which, and I think you described it very vividly, integrates good mentors from anywhere in the world, guides from anywhere in the world, academic institutions, students from all over the world, I think that is the future. If you look at some of your IT students, so if you look at the future of IT, we are saying that a time will come when nobody will buy a computer anymore. You don't need computers. I mean, ultimately, everything will be on the cloud. All you will have to do, very similar, today when you need electricity, you don't think of going and buying a power plant. You just, I mean, install an electric connection in your house, put a switch on. Information tomorrow will be accessed exactly like that. I mean, today we are doing a project in Gurgaon across maybe 2,000 small companies who are suppliers to Maruti Suzuki. And the basic theme is, for 15,000 rupees per month, without buying a single computer, they should be able to have all their manufacturing planning, their materials management, finance, everything done. And this is the future of technology. So very similar to this, if this is the future of technology, where computers will be all in the cloud somewhere, and you will access primarily through access devices. The mobile phone will access more data than today's PCs and laptops and Apple iMacs will do. So I think that's really what we're talking about here. Similarly, there is absolutely no reason why education cannot be accessed through technology. Good projects, as was rightly said, cannot be leveraged through technology. And I think that's the advantage. I was also very impressed by the quality of projects, and I think I must thank the organizers for making the effort to find these projects. But yesterday I asked my team to go through all the projects that the jury was asked to evaluate, and asked them to come up with 6 projects which they found really innovative. And my team is all young people like you, age of 24, 25, 26. And they came up with some really fantastic projects. I mean, one person has come up with a project which is so appropriate for India. I mean, if India, we are proud of one thing, it is indiscipline. Even today in the great city of Pune, we have not found a way to get people to wear helmets for 2 meters. Okay, and I've heard all kinds of excuses saying, you know, we have to stop on the way home from office to buy vegetables for my wife. And if I leave the helmet on the scooter, somebody will steal it, so I don't wear a helmet. I mean, this is classic Pune. But this project, which I know, any of you here may have done that, it's a project which says that, look, if somebody is not wearing a seatbelt when he is driving his car, till 40 kilometers per hour, which is okay speed, nothing will happen. But if the seatbelt is not on, this car cannot pick up speed beyond 40 kilometers per hour. So you're automatically forced to wear your seatbelt. And the whole afternoon I've been thinking, can we put a sensor on somebody's head so that if you don't wear a helmet, this motorcycle will stop automatically? Because sometimes that seems to be the only way in which people do that. Sorry, you've already done that? Oh, your project. I think it's a fantastic one. See, because this is simple innovation. Both Ajay and I are great believers in Professor Anil Gupta of IIM Ahmedabad. And he does innovation for India. Because innovation is not just the iPod and the Apple Mac and everything else. Innovation is these simple things which can make driving safer. which can make the quality of life for every Indian much easier. Innovation is, I think, what you've done, this whole technology, and I'm quite happy to support it from Zensar or any which way you want to make this platform something that we will use. I mean, and somebody rightly said, I mean, today we recruit close to 1,000 young students from engineering colleges every year. And we have the standard list of 30 colleges we'll go to, and 400 other colleges will write to us. But we don't know, because our team doesn't have the time to go to Bhilai or Raipur or wherever. Maybe the college is very good. But if we could access a great project, because of which we could talk to a great project team, interact with the mentors, everything on the internet, I think it would open up an entirely new opportunity for companies like Zensar, for academic institutions, and for students who are, as I said, not studying in the most prosperous cities, and still making this happen. So my belief is, I mean, I know there's a lot of gloom and doom about India today, but this is a country which has huge potential. There is absolutely no doubt in my mind that whether the economy grows at 6% or 7% this year, in the long term, we have a huge challenge and a huge opportunity. And it is young people like you, you know, who have the initiative, the enthusiasm to make things happen, that will make it happen. On behalf of CII, NASSCOM, and of course Zensar Technologies, my company, I am delighted to be here. And I think we will do whatever it takes to support your endeavors and make this more successful. So thank you very much. Many real pleasure.